57-year-old Lendl C. proudly shows off his tidy one-bedroom apartment, which overlooks the 5 freeway in East Los Angeles. The unit's bathroom is so big, he keeps his bike in it.
I think it'd look good there.
And there's plenty of room for his collection of hats, many of which tout his military service.
My primary job was in motor T, transportation. Driving.
C served in the Marines for more than 21 years, including Desert Storm in Iraq, before retiring in 1998. But despite his successful military career, after his fiancée passed away from a stroke in 2004, C found himself in a downward spiral.
That's when the drinking and everything really, really kicked in.
For you?
Yes. I just fell apart and lost everything.
So you found yourself where?
Found myself in the streets around Culver City and Santa Monica.
From one day to the next, you were homeless?
Yes.
Before he moved into this apartment last October, C had been homeless off and on for a decade.
Everything that I made was mostly spent drinking.
Famously, sunny Los Angeles has long been known as the homeless capital of America, from beachy communities like Santa Monica and Venice to Skid Row downtown. There are about 45,000 homeless people in LA County, about 4,000 of whom are veterans. The number of homeless vets in the city of LA has fallen by about one-third since 2009, and last year, the city joined an ambitious national effort already underway to completely end veteran homelessness by the end of this year. LA's commitment coincided with an event last July attended by First Lady Michelle Obama, who has championed veterans' initiatives for the Obama administration.
Make no mistake, it is an aggressive goal. But we have seen time and time again that if you break these numbers down, then this problem becomes imminently solvable.
I don't think anybody's had the confidence that we'd ever be able to make a dent in homelessness. We've just come to accept that we manage homelessness, that we try to make it less bad, but we never make it better.
Los Angeles Mayor Eric Garcetti is a former Navy reservist himself. He says the city's efforts to end homelessness among veterans is different than how things used to be in LA.
Our policy was very lazy. I just do housing. I just feed them. I'm a free health clinic. And it admirably dealt with the crisis of people potentially dying on our streets, but it never turned their lives around permanently. That's what's changed now.
The first step of this new model is a permanent house, funded mostly at government expense, with services then added around the resident. It's called permanent supportive housing, and that's what Lendl C. found himself in. C. lives in this complex that houses only formerly homeless veterans. While there is no firm program that he has to follow, he has access to support services, including on-site case managers, mental health counseling, substance abuse treatment, and even a community garden. Officials in LA point to research showing nearly 90% of chronically homeless people remained housed after 5 years using this model. For C, who's been sober for more than 2 years, it's more than he'd hoped for.
It feels good. Sometimes I walk around the apartment, no TV or nothing on, and just singing for no reason at all. And then I catch myself doing it, and I start laughing. I say, you must be going crazy now. But I'm just happy.
A good crazy.
It feel good.
There's no time limit on staying in the apartment. Residents generally pay 30% of their income in rent. For C, that's $470 from his pension. The rest is subsidized with a federal voucher specifically for homeless veterans. Since 2008, nearly 80,000 of these vouchers for homeless vets have been awarded around the country.
I'll sign it. Thank you.
Christine Margiota runs Home for Good for the United Way of Greater Los Angeles, which has coordinated the efforts of hundreds of service providers working to help homeless vets. She says housing for the homeless, including veterans, is less expensive than trying to care for people on the street, which costs nearly $1 billion annually in LA.
Because that person is using the emergency rooms for their primary health care, they may be cycling in and out of jail or prison. They're really suffering out on our streets. What we know is that permanent supportive housing is actually 40% cheaper than leaving someone on the streets and in our minds doing nothing.
But despite the progress made, there's no shortage of homeless people, including veterans, on the streets of Los Angeles. Early one morning this past March, we went to Skid Row in downtown L.A. with outreach workers from U.S. Vets, a nonprofit veteran support group. There we met Benjamin Barraza Jr.
Can I ask you how long you've been on the street or
how
homeless?
Long? Right now, since I've been
out of prison 2 years ago.
You've been on the street for 2 years?
Yeah, so I...
Baratza is an Army veteran who served from 1971 to 1974. But he told us that he'd also spent time in prison. Since he'd been out, he'd been staying in Skid Row shelters. He showed us the few essentials that he keeps with him.
I got it all here, man. You know, this is my little kit. You know, I got to keep it right. You know, got to keep clean, smell clean.
Despite qualifying for a federal housing voucher, when we met him, Baratza had not been able to find a permanent house. For him and many others on the street, finding an affordable apartment or placement in a facility with services isn't easy.
Is it frustrating?
Oh man, it's right now I'm getting a headache right now, just thinking about
all the things you have to deal with, yeah, just to get a place?
Well, because I can't get around.
Right.
I mean, I'm obese, I put weight on. You know, while I was in prison, my mother died on me.
Wow, I'm so sorry.
You know, I caught hepatitis C, how in the world?
Even with the focus of the federal government and local officials on veteran homelessness, Baratza and thousands of other tough cases are still on LA streets.
I was on the street this morning, and we ran into some veterans.
Yeah.
From my eyes, it looks like an impossible task.
Yeah.
These are people who are in dire straits. How do you deal with that population?
The more you go into the population, the tougher it is to achieve that goal, because towards the end, it is the people who are the most service-resistant, who most deeply experience mental health challenges, people have PTSD, substance abuse issues, which often intermingle with each other. Some will take more time, but I'm confident we can make sure that each one of them has a pathway off our streets.
The state of Connecticut, as well as some cities including Phoenix, Salt Lake City, New Orleans, and Houston, said they've been able to house their entire populations of chronically homeless vets with permanent supportive housing. But Los Angeles will not be able to reach that goal by the end of the year. Data released in May show that there was actually a small increase in the number of homeless vets in the city of Los Angeles since 2013. And in August, Mayor Garcetti backed away from his pledge to house all homeless vets by the end of the year. In a statement to PBS NewsHour Weekend, the mayor's office said in part, "We are housing more than 192 veterans every month, but every day 4 to 5 veterans are falling into homelessness, making it difficult to catch up. We hope to reach functional zero for veteran homelessness by July 2016. In September, Mayor Garcetti allocated an additional $13 million in city funds to expand subsidies for homeless people. And in November, the LA City Council declared a shelter crisis, which provides expanded access to temporary shelters as the weather gets colder and with the onset of the rainy El Niño season. The City Council also pledged to spend $100 million on helping LA's tens of thousands of homeless. But it's not clear where or when the money will be available.